Greetings everyone, hello and welcome back once more to Anno 1800, our Megacity survival, looking at the large shipyard, the advanced large shipyard that we have built in the last episode, finally now, a modded version of course, and yeah, building the biggest and most powerful ships ever existed in Anno really, right? And construction is on its way in 26 minutes, so in this very episode most likely, we're going to finish the first one out of these bad boys. Of course, we're not stopping there and waiting. We have lots of stuff to do. Before we dive right into the work, if you like my content, please consider supporting me on Patreon. I would really appreciate that. Now, let's unload some items here on board. And that's the Mulch Shrimp, right? And the Mulch Shrimp is such a great ship for us because it's really hauling in so many beautiful items. And with the last haul, it got us a few more things that are going to be very, very helpful for us. The first thing is we can now finally fortify this side of Panagos. It's been a while, right? And of course, it's tricky. Oh, there's already something coming in again. Before we fortify that, let's get rid of those cannon towers here. The reason for that is those cannon towers are being attacked rather quickly by the incoming ships. They're weak, so the ships can attack them before these fire, and I get under siege. So I think they actually helped the enemy keeping up that siege status for longer. Now, the closest line of defense is here that the enemy ships can attack, and this is within the range of the big baddie them. So I think with that, it's getting harder for them now to actually attack me, right? That was a tiny mistake on my part. They're a little detail. Let's get over here, because this area, of course, is going to be important in many ways. It's our tourist area, right? So we're going to have a tourist port here. At the same time, we'll need some coastal buildings here still. And that's the sand mines, and that's also the fisheries. It's not really necessary to have them, because the docklands can make sure of that. But it's, well, reserving or wasting two slots in my docklands. So, yeah, that's that. Let's have the big baddies moved over here, because of course I want my tourists looking at some proper defenses there. And it just makes sense, right? This is a dangerous area for tourists alike, and they should see that. We will need a harbor master office then for this area. No, I'm not helping you, Archie, right now. Unfortunately, we can't afford that. Where is it again? Come on, there it is. Alright, getting us a proper harbor master office out here. This is where we're going to have the tourist port. We should probably build it already. Just in case, just so that we reserve the space for it, right? It's this one here. And we might actually have it then in that side, on that side. Or should we have it closer? I think we are going to have it closer anyway. Let's move it in a bit, right? It's going to be somewhere over there then. And with that, we can have this area. There is a lighthouse. We should probably have this too. It's a nice ornament, really, that we can have in this area. I'm showing, paving the way, showing the lights, right? And then we have just proper defense lined up. Lots of big baddies. Four of them might be my go-to here. Of course, we're boosting all of them. And then we have those towers out there, the flamethrowers. Let's actually get rid of them here. The anti-armor guns, we no longer need them. Those ruins cost me attractiveness anyway, which is never really a good thing. And then we're just going in and build our own defenses here, right? So close to the big baddies. A bit, and yeah, as many as possible. That's the flamethrowers. That I would like to have. We also will need some anti-armor guns, for sure. Even though they are quite expensive, so in that case, hurting me a bit, but they're absolutely required. Let's have some fort here. By the way, let's just make sure that I can squeeze them in a bit. Perfect. So that we can have more of them together. And I just like to mix it up a bit, the whole thing, right? And then another row of flamethrowers over here as well, finishing that line of defense together with that big baddie that we have over there. Is this enough? Well, I guess we'll figure it out soon anyway, once we build all of it. And then together with the harbor master office right here in the center. The problem is, will this defend those coastlines here? I don't think so, right? So if the enemy ships stay here, they can attack and destroy all of that, and I can't do anything about it. The problem is, I can't have three of these defensive structure areas, because it's too costly, right? This is going to cost me well over 100 influence already, and we need to build ships as well. This is already, yeah, almost completed, right? And this is the next one, because building just a few is a waste, because it gets easily destroyed. Building too many is a waste too, because it just wastes too much influence. So we need to keep it in the middle here, and I can only build one more additional area. And we need a tourist port at some point. It's absolutely required for the city advancement, so it needs to be here. We'll just see how it turns out, right? Defense-wise, I can have this row of defense also up here, so this will increase the range a bit, right? So we're probably going to fire all the way up to this point now. That's fine. And we'll just see how it turns out then, what the enemy does. Let's activate the Harbor Master Office with Colonel Barzali once more. So attack speed, 20% increase. We also got the Cannoneer, 15% damage increase per shot and 600 hit points. And then we got an activated item, the Oxidophone. All defense turrets gain 30% morale in addition. That's something I like a lot. Let's build some big baddies. That's going to be quite costly on my advanced weapons. We don't have that many anymore. And let's build a lot of fire towers. Poof. Oh, there were already 100 influence. That's that. Some advanced weapons. There it is. Anti-armor. Two more. And then some more flamethrowers. I wonder how many more I can build. There is some more flamethrowers on that side. And that's the end of it. Now we're out of steel beams. And probably pretty low on weapons already. That's plenty though, right? So they're boosted as well. So this is already going to be pretty tough. A pretty tough nut for anyone to crack. Let's build those sand mines, because I would like to see how the enemy reacts to that now, right? And if we can keep them active and alive, then we might just get rid of the sand import again from the Docklands, because that is then not required any longer. Lovely! A new defense line is coming up. We still have resources for that lighthouse, so let's build it. Let's have it then here at the end of my defensive structures, right? Not so bad for now. We'll just see the onslaught that will inevitably come to this area. Next up, we actually have some further industry we need to build, and that is the champagne. Now, in the last episode, we finished our vineyards over here that are now working for us, right? They're also getting the grape fertility already in. No boosts at the moment, right? Though I do have an item that would still boost them a bit. I think we were having it. There it is, right? Expert planter, 50% productivity increase, and also module increase. So we could still make them even bigger if we want that. If we're ever getting low on that. Next up on the list would be now the wine cellar. Also, more glass most likely. Let's check it out there real quick. We're very close here now, right? So only plus two. So I will need more of these. And for that, I would like to organize my industry zone again a bit. There is the power plant. So having those glass smelters here will totally electrify them. Let's move that one away a bit and also clear some space here and this and add some more of these glass smelters then to the region. Wait a second, let's make this a bit better. We can actually make it like so, I think. I mean, yeah, could be tricky because there is the coastline coming up now. It's possible. Four of them are at least possible. That's perfect. And they're all getting their electrification. Very nice. Let's build all three of them right away. And we still have room for more here then, right? That's six more. No, it's way more than that, right? It's four. That's more. That's, yeah, 14 more glass that we have right now. That should be enough for my champagne cellars. Now, we do need three, I think it was. Yeah, so I'm going to go with 4 to 6 consumption short-term wise. Let's make it 6. We can produce 2 per minute. Boosted, it's 4 per minute. So 2 champagne cellars under electrification would already be enough. We have the power plant here. So having the champagne cellar in this region, yeah, is possible, right? It's a non-pollution, low-key building that actually fits well to any kind of city. We got the marquetry workshop here that I no longer need, because we do have the marquetry over here. And I'm pretty sure we can find us another slot somewhere here. There it is already. Right, so let's move that buy station a bit away. Another huge collier comes out. With that, we can move those furnaces down and make us room for another marquetry workshop just here. Also, it looks much cleaner this way. Very good. And with that, we have actually 2 slots here available. This warehouse can be moved down here. And we should... Ooh, this is going to be tight, but it should be possible. Disrupting the street here is fine, as we still get the maximum electricity. And with that, I can build it. Let's build both of them right away. Or is that too much? Producing four. It's fine. Let's have both of them working here. And it just looks lovely, I think, beside my residences then, right? So these are industry buildings that I consider fit well together with a city. Or with the city layout in general, right? So having them close to that. Let's upgrade the warehouse here to look a bit proper as well. And with that, the champagne production is on its way. Let's close it again for now. And that's the last one, the last need for my investors before we can boost them further to skyscrapers. By the way, there is an even better item available right now to me, and that is the medal winning producer effect, the vineyards. They only not only produce 40% more, but they also produce champagne as an extra good. It's probably not that much since it's only every eighth, and we already produce eight, but let's just see what the boost here would be if we have it available. And you know what? Actually, this is looking like we might use champagne as an export good pretty soon. It's another ton there for free, at least, right? And getting also some 40% more boost out of my vineyards leads to more grapes. And we're not even at the end of this, right? So there is another item we can use. And then we have lots of space for more expansion. So this is looking pretty great there overall for having champagne being used as my next export good in the Docklands. Might be worth it. Let's finish some of those buildings over there. And yeah, champagne is coming in. Let's have a look other than outside of that. City development, because I think we should be able to upgrade a few more people again. Especially here, we got lots of people that will join Investorhood. And also here. I think here we should start with it, because this is more like the downtown area. Problem though is, of course, steel beams. So I cannot even go that deep into it, right? Also, workers need steel beams for upgrades. So we really need to wait there. How many steel beams do we produce right now? 23 tons per minute. Sounds like a lot. Probably is a lot. Already fully boosted. There's not that much else I can do here. Electrified, items, working conditions. No, workers are not really happy, so I should probably not do it. By the way, what could we do here? We do have the copper and the zinc. That is something I don't really need as boosted stuff anymore, but it's not adding a lot of unhappiness, right? A bit. But we don't need it. We have the sand that I'm importing right now, so we also don't need that. We have the oil that I would probably keep. We have the furnaces that I certainly don't need anymore. Instead, we could really do it the other way around. 25% less production actually gives me happiness, right? And if we look at that, this should still be fine. We're still having a huge surplus of 30 tons of steel per minute. That means I could further tone it down and actually get me some happiness here out. It's a risky thing here to do, but it is actually totally valid in this area. We have the copper and the zinc. We don't really need it since I'm importing brass directly where necessary. With that, we could get some happiness out there again. In addition, looking at sausage and bread. Bread I would not do because we're producing chocolate with that as well. Sausage though, I can reduce, right? We don't need sausage for anything else and I'm not using it for the Docklands. Reducing the production of sausage gives me another two happiness for the workers. And with that, out of negative 11, to neutral happiness for the workers. Great stuff. I think we can do the same thing for engineer used production. So we have the advanced weapons here already. Let's actually reduce this because it's really not necessary. And then we have, let's just check this, marketing workshops. We have a lot of gramophone production as far as I know. And I'm not going to use gramophones for the Docklands. So I could probably, unfortunately it doesn't do anything. Actually it did. It gave me one, right? So this is something. There's not much else I could do here that would not lead to anything. So let's keep it like that for the moment. Engineer, we have to live with a bit of unhappiness there for the moment. We also have finally some champagne on board, so let's go ahead and also activate champagne for my investors. 25 more coins per building and 2 more investors per building. Not a lot, it's a small minor boost. It's probably a bit more than it would cost really initially to produce. And with that, all the needs are fulfilled for the investors, and theoretically we can get them up to skyscraper level now. By the way, We are really low on steel beams. Let's purchase them. I'm not usually someone who purchases building materials, but in that case, I'm going to make an exception. And Archie perhaps also has some other stuff for us. And I need to interrupt here because this is the fleet the Admiral gathers right now in front of Panagos. So let's go ahead and try to build a few more of my towers here, right? That's the flamethrowers that we added. We still have the anti-armor ones, but I think we're going to need even more flamethrowers. Let's just check this out. I think here we can still have a few more. Yep. And up here we should also... I mean, they're not getting boosted then, but that's okay. Having them here, an outer layer, another one that we probably should have. And big baddie-wise, steel beams. So the ship with the steel beams hopefully is already on its way. Ah, no, I totally forgot. Let's send it in. Let's do this. Alright, I think that was enough to scare them off. And off they go again. Perfect. So no need to worry here. This is going to be tough for them, especially since they're boosted. Also with propaganda, right? The 37% that we got from the propaganda warmongery is pretty nice on that too. So we're almost doubling the speed of what they can achieve. The steel beams though we can still use, of course, for upgrades, which we definitely should be doing. Let's also head back to Manola there a while, because we want to continue with getting the Artista workforce up more and more. For that, we don't need way more people though, right? So either we boost the Artista workforce or work population with demands that we can meet, or more buildings in general. Speaking about demands, there are a few things that actually are quite feasible. That would be the champagne, that gives me two Artistas in addition, and light bulbs. Both of them we produce in higher quantities right now in Panagos. So this is a way of boosting our population there further. Let's have this one here as a little chapel park, right? And then we can have some more... do we keep it like that? Some more buildings here like that. Yeah, let's have another row of funnelers. And I think for this area there, let's also go ahead with a boxing arena, because at some point we're going to need it anyway. And then we can have some more blocks of houses here. So this is all going to be a nice city area there, leading all the way up here. This is looking rather similar to what I already had in my last year's Megacity edition, right? Leading up here probably to the monument, because this is the only place where I can think about the Christo statue, right? It just makes sense up there. Nothing else would make sense in this regard. Boosting a few more Honoleros might make sense. That would be with the felts. With soccer balls. Do we have a nice production of that? I think this will put it out of whack. Yeah, this is too much. Too much consumption for little gain. Plus one Honolero per building is really not something you can live on. It's not okay. Alright, and I think this area would be next. This is my timber production for the moment. But this can easily be built somewhere else or moved somewhere else. That's the sawmills that we have, right? So we can have them up there. This is a smaller zone, right? And some of them we can move. Some of them we probably can just delete and be happy with that as well. Let's not forget that we also do need some logs, quite a bit of logs actually, for my rum distilleries and whatnot. So that's that. Move the warehouse over. You provide. And with that, a new area available as well for city development. This is what we probably should be doing right away. I do have my marketplace there once more, so this is providing for the whole area then. And then we do need another chapel area. Let's actually go ahead with a little park then once more. Something along the lines. There is a chapel ready, so we can have it a bit further in, right? And it can actually look towards the marketplace there. There's this little plaza area in the middle. And then we have a bit of a chapel garden surrounding it. And then city. There is the problem with the tracks here right now. I'm probably going to change this a bit, right? So let's have a look. Let's make it like so. because this is also not really... Can I move the bridge? Unfortunately, you can't move the bridge. Because I want to keep a bit of a distance between that and the surrounding, of course. Either with, we could say, a wall once more. We could go with the industrial wall. A low-key wall or the brick wall. Let's have the brick wall. I think it's safer. For the children and stuff. I'm always thinking about the children here. And also on that side. Keeping the train separated from the rest. And here, of course, we can then have a nice gate on both sides, connecting the districts. Right. Like so. And then just trees. There are already some palm trees on that side, but we could also just go ahead with temperate ones, tropical forests along the wall. As a further layer of separation between my people and the tracks, that is. And then we have this area available, of course, for some proper city building now. Probably going to keep a bit of space there to the coastline. Should we do this or just another block? Go ahead with another block, really. Right, and this leads then to the oil harbor, perhaps. I don't know why. Perhaps it does something to it. A boxing arena is definitely required at some point here. So let's just make room for it right away. And then we can have more buildings here. I think we already have... I mean, we have the fountain one. Yep. Your people are starting to get sick. Get the fountain over. And then some more buildings here and here. That's some good... Condellera workforce coming in, and that's going to be very important for us then in the future for upgrading. Speaking about upgrades, I can go ahead and upgrade the whole next blocks here to artisters. It's so colorful and bright, it almost hurts my eyes. Those artista buildings, still beautiful to look at. Promise me you won't go to sea again. And with that, we continue onwards in the next episode. Stay tuned!